Guys, it's that time of year again for the holiday gift guide from Getzone.com. And today we're going to be taking a look at long guns. We're going to start out with some really unique options. This is a Chiappa, and this is really cool. But we have a number of different items that we want to show you. We've also done a handgun edition and a gear and accessories edition. We really appreciate Getzone for putting all this together and all the companies that joined in for the gift guide. Guys, there have been a lot of cool items in the gift guide, but the APF Armory 300 Win Mag is my favorite. In fact, I love taking this out. I didn't know what I was going to think at first. Being in 300 Win Mag, it's a pretty powerful round. In fact, 300 Win Mag was Chris Kyle's favorite caliber. He said that it was in a completely different universe. And so this is their MLR Compact. It has one of the Proof Research carbon fiber barrels. The gun, even though this is a larger frame gun, it only weighs 9.2 pounds, which is really good for this size rifle. And here we have a 308 next to the 300 Win Mag. And you can see the massive difference. They are both 30 caliber bullets, but man, that extra powder and the belt at the bottom, this thing really puts out some velocity. In fact, at the muzzle, it's 3,150 feet per second, and the energy is 3,305 foot-pounds. It is a beast. It's taken the Big Five in Africa, and it will take anything on the North American continent. Now with that, you get four five-round APF magazines. These are proprietary with the rifle, and they are polymer. It comes with the three-port MLR muzzle brake, and it's stainless steel. It has ports along the top as well. And then you can start to see the carbon fiber barrel right here. And that carbon fiber barrel goes all the way through this 15 and a half inch handguard, which is made by APF Armory. It has a rifle length gas system, so it's actually going to help tame the recoil, and you get an Picatinny accessory rail at the front for your bipods. The upper and lower receivers are billet aluminum. These are made by APF. And of course, it has all those same features you get with the AR style rifle. It also has the CMC 3.5 flat blade trigger. This thing is phenomenal. And we have the Magpul ACS stock, has battery compartments, small compartment. I mean, this is a very comfortable stock to rest your cheek on. And then also it has one of the Ergo Sure Grips. I really like the texturing. It has a rubber overmold over the grip. A very comfortable rifle to sit behind. And the bolt carrier group has a black nitride finish on it. And guys, I wanted to pull that bolt carrier group out. Look at that thing. It is long and it is massive. And what's really funny is this little buffer is so small compared to your standard AR-15 buffer. And actually the AR-15 buffer weighs a little more, but this is an incredible system and this thing is a beast. And as you can see, the receiver has some styling features to it, and you have your bolt hold open feature right here. Charging handle does have an extension, especially if you're running optics, which you should on this rifle. And it's solid. Guys, we took this out to the range, and I really would like to have gotten it out to greater distances. We were just hitting up to 300 yards. We have a 1,000-yard range, actually a mile range. This is capable easily of doing. I was really seriously impressed with the lack of bullet drop between 100 and 300 yards. In fact, it was only 10.2 inches at 300 yards, and we had it sighted in at 100 yards. It was raining like crazy, but we got it out, and I'm going to tell you guys, behind this rifle, it's like shooting a 308, or maybe even less. I mean, the recoil is so mild on it, and typically with 300 Win Mag, you know, you have significant recoil. So you're getting a really softer shooting gun that has a highly capable round. That Proof Research carbon fiber barrel, it just really reduces the weight, but that muzzle brake, to me, really tames the recoil. The rifle's definitely 9.2 pounds, so it's fairly heavy, but still, it was such a pleasure to shoot. But you can see the rain coming down, and guys, we were hitting headshots at 300 yards without any problem. Overall, sitting at the bench, this thing just performed phenomenally. I'd love to get this out to 6, 7, even 1,000 yards, and just see what kind of ballistics this thing can really produce. The APF Armory, which the APF actually stands for Alex Pro Firearms. This is a fantastic rifle, beautifully put together. The guys over at APF do the upper and lower receivers. A lot of the parts are directly from them, made right here in the USA. This is an incredible rifle. In 300 Win Mag, It's a beast that's tamed. Next, we have the Charles Daly Model 202, and this is an over and under shotgun, and it's in 410. Now, they make a number of different gauges, 20 and 12 gauge, and a number of other different models in the over and under series. But the over and under is just such a classic. They're beautiful shotguns, traditional for hunting, for clays, for skeet, trap. But this is a very well-finished shotgun. This is their black chrome and silver model. It has a 26-inch barrel, and it's 43 inches in overall length. And you can use up to 3-inch shells, which gives you a lot of choices, even with the 2 3/4. And there's so many different type loads out there, 410, even self-defense loads that are pretty serious. Now, starting at the front, we do have extended choke tubes. You can switch these out. These are Beretta Benelli compatible tubes. And then you have a fiber optic front bead. And the 26-inch barrels have a vent rib on the top, and it does have checkering all along the top to cut down on glare. And the aluminum receiver on both sides has this beautiful engraving. And this is kind of a matte silver color. It really sets this off. We have oiled walnut handguard with checkering. Buttstock is also oiled walnut, and it has a pistol grip, nice checkering all the way down the grip. And we have a rubberized butt pad at the back. And to engage the safety, you have to pull over this little white disc to make it go forward. Just gives it an extra safety factor. That way it doesn't slip, then you lock it back in. Silver trigger with a black handguard, and this is metal. And when you pop those barrels open, it does have an ejector right here that pushes out those spent shells. We have a lever on the handguard. Pull it down, pull off your handguard, hit the lever, bring out your barrels, and it comes completely down. So now you have two pieces, really easy to pack up and stow away. Take your handguard, set it back into place, pull down on your lever, and it locks back in. Man, this thing, taking it to the range, I mean, it's just so soft to shoot with that 410. And, you know, just slow load, you open it up, you put your rounds in, load in a couple of rounds, close it up, fire it. I mean, it really slows things down a bit, but excellent for hunting, excellent for skeet shooting. You've got two barrels right there. All you got to do is pull the trigger once and then pull it the second time for the second clay. Same thing with bird hunting. I mean, it gives you two shots really fast. Loading and unloading is not as important when you're hunting. And of course, we have these high-speed, low-drag rigs for shotgun. But this just kind of brings it back to the old days. And man, this is a really beautiful shotgun. The one thing about over and under shotguns is they can be extremely expensive. This one coming from Charles Daly, these are made in Turkey, which Turkey is making some really high quality firearms. The price is coming in at about $459, which is a great price for a beautiful over and under. And if you're out there in the field, I mean, people are going to take a look at this shotgun. And really, when I pulled this out of the box, I was like, wow, that is a beautiful firearm. Guys, the Chiappa Little Badger TDX. This is a really cool little breakdown rifle option that I've never seen anything like it before. It is the smallest rifle on the market, and these are made in Italy. It packs up in a small tube. You unpack it. It comes in two pieces. You can put those together. I mean, it's a very simple little rifle. It's a breakdown 22 action. It is single shot, and it's very simple to put together and then to assemble and ready to fire. With single shot, you'd be surprised at how fast you can get those rounds out. The one cool thing is the buttstock actually is a shell holder, so you can place 22 rounds in the small little butt pad, and then when you need them, it's real natural just to reach back and pull one off and put it in. And again, guys, for a single shot break action type firearm, this is a fast little gun. And guys, with the 22, there's just no recoil whatsoever. It is so easy and soft to shoot. I really enjoyed it. Great for a survival rifle. Great to be able to pack away in that small tube if you need to. And then you can stow it away and keep it from getting damaged. And yet, you've got it really handy to pull out whenever you need it. Just line up your white dot, take the action, and that allows it to fit right into the action. Close it, and then put it on the red. And now you're ready to fire. It does have a half cock, so if I need just to put it out to get it off the bullet, I can. Right here is your lever to be able to break this down and to be able to load. And guys, it's so easy to load. Just place your round in here, close it up, fire, bring it out, and then the little ejector will push that round out and you can pull it out and reload. Such a small little minimalist survival rifle option. There is a Picatinny rail back here at the rear, and then you have a quad rail at the front. You can put sights, you can put a light on here. I mean, you can do a number of different things. Also, it has your M1 carbine style aperture sight, which is fully adjustable. And then here at the front, you have that same M1 carbine style little front post, but then you have these ears that protect it. And it is 1/2 by 28 threads. It has a thread protector. So you could actually put a suppressor on here, or for that matter, a little compensator. 16.5-inch barrel has this wire stock, which is one piece. Now right here is a little knob, and you just turn it. You can bring your little butt pad down and then just tighten it up. And now you're ready to go. Has some traction on the back of the butt stock. And it has little shell holders for your 22. You can put six on each side for a total of 12. And you can pull those off. It makes it really natural to reach back there and to pull them off to load the rifle. Now we did a review of the original Little Badger right here. And the one thing it does is it comes down and around and makes a really small package. But it doesn't break down like the TDX. I mean, this thing is just phenomenal. And again, you just bring it around. You just line up your dots to the white, and then you can just pull it off. And now we can get back in that tube, and man, it is a small package. Chiappa also offers models in 22 long rifle, 22 magnum, 17 HMR. But in the little TDX, it comes in only 22. There's a lot of different options. Guys, these are the coolest little small rifles. Again, they're breakdown. They're a little slow as far as modern standards, but really, you can get really fast with these. Great for hunting. Great to put as in a survival pack. I mean, it's just so handy. It weighs 2.9 pounds, and it's 31 inches in overall length, but it breaks down to about 17 inches. And guys, I will be doing a full review on this. It'll probably be on my Sensible Prepper channel. But guys, this is such a cool option. I love what Chiappa is doing. All right, guys, next is the AR Takedown Tool. This is a hammerless impact technology. Honestly, when I first saw this, I thought, what in the world? How can this do so much? But this was actually voted best invention at the 2022 SHOT Show this past year. So this is a disassembly tool. It uses hammerless impact technology. You have a spring. You have two ends that are brass, all steel here. One thing about these is they're all made in the USA, even down to the packaging, the printing, everything, and assembled and finished. So this is a truly USA-made item. This produces 5,000 PSI. And when you bring back the tool, and there's little grab handles, when you bring them back, it impacts and it forces pins out. And so we're going to take a look at a few of the features of this, but guys, I'll just tell you, this is a really cool idea. We're going to start out with the most common use of breaking down your AR-15, and that's just push out your takedown pin and pivot pin. And sometimes you do need a punch if they're really tight and a hammer. And so we're going to just take it, bring this back. There we go. And it pops it through. And so now it gets it started. You can just pull it to the other side. You can see how far it came out. And then we can just pull these pins. It makes it really simple to be able to maintain and clean your firearm. So that is just the easiest. Now you notice there are cups on the ends. And one side's smaller, one side's larger. And the brass is going to protect from keeping your finish intact. And guys, how many times have we taken a hammer and a punch and, you know, just sideswiped it a little bit? But this is your buffer tube, and really just take it, push down, and it pops it right out. That's another simple function of this tool. Trigger pins, make sure it's set, pop them out. Now your trigger pin's coming right out. Now each one has steel little handles or grips. You can pull this up, and as you pop them, it will create up to 5,000 PSI. Nice little spring attached. Now, one thing about this too, and this is probably a reason why most people will just buy this by itself. This piece comes off, and you can use this
as a takedown pivot pin, especially that little small detent that seems to get lost. And we're going to demonstrate that as well. And the other side also just unscrews and you can replace these. I'm sure there may be even different tools coming.
Now here's your pivot pin. And your pivot pin is held in with a small little detent and a spring that runs in this channel. And this is one place that you tend to lose this little detent and possibly the spring, because there is a channel that runs in your takedown pin that holds that detent, and it allows it to open and close without this falling out and popping out. So take the AR takedown tool and unscrew the small end, and you want this small piece here. And inside the pin on the other side, there is a small little hole right here. So I'm going to push it in, depress my detent, then I'm going to turn my takedown pin as I rotate my takedown tool end. Now I'm going to pull this out and slowly pull this without losing the detent or the spring. Okay, so here we have the detent and the spring. And so we can replace these if we need to. You can clean it out, do whatever. But one of the big tricks is replacing this, and that's probably the hardest, is to get this back in without this flying out. So take your AR takedown tool, bring it all the way through, and just depress the spring and catch it behind the brass piece. Now you'll notice that there is that hole in your brass, so you want to make sure that you don't let that spring go through there. So we're going to take our detent and put it into the hole while we turn the tool. Now take that small end again and just push in that detent, being careful not to let it slip. Once you get it inside, you can turn the entire tool. And that way, that detent is locked into place. The hardest part is getting your pivot pin back in without letting that spring knock it off track. And so you can set it into that little hole there. Just hold on to it. Expect that detent to pop out like that. And just keep going. And then it locks into the channel. So now we have it locked into place. And it makes it a lot easier. And you don't have to go around searching for that dumb detent and spring for hours. Honestly, guys, that task alone is worth this tool.
Now, it's 6 1/4 inches long, and it weighs 2 ounces. Really easy to throw into your bag. And again, guys, thousands of uses. They also make a number of other tools. In fact, there's a whole kit with this hammerless impact technology, even for the AK-47. And even for your roll pins, different things. And you can check the artakedowntool.com website to get all the details. But guys, whether maintenance, whether cleaning, adding on, if you're taking off, this is a great tool to have in your toolbox.
So guys, I hope you've enjoyed the long gun edition of the holiday gift guide from getzone.com. There were some pretty cool things in there. And this little Chiappa is just a little beast. I love it. But we really appreciate GetZone.com for putting all this together. They are one of the largest Second Amendment friendly video platforms out there. And also all the companies that joined in with us. Also check out the handgun edition and the gear and accessories edition as well. I think you'll find some pretty cool items for not only for family and friends, but probably for yourself. Be strong, be of good courage. God bless America, long live the Republic, and Merry Christmas. Pull down on your lever. Now, Chiappa also. Did I say Chiappa?
And then also, you can remove this side.
2022 edition. Okay. We're going to take our detent and we're just going to place it into that hole.